Hello, Malcolm. Hello, everyone else. Welcome back to Halcyon 6. Okay, well, since last episode, I just did a little quick thing in the background. I went and did the appropriate research, and figured out what I thought was a good combination of Tier 2 starships, and then we actually took a gamble. What's this? Elite Wraithers, we're not going to worry about them. Took a gamble and took the time to construct the fleet, because we had the materials to do it. During which the Krull spawned a bunch more fleets, and we've got a really short time span left on the Boomerang Colony. So we're going to have some Krull to deal with. However, we've got three new ships, so Boomerang is where? Here. Send the fleet. Woof Woof Gurry in transit to Boomerang. This is our new fleet. That's why it's a zero fuel cost. I will just show you the ships of this fleet. So, where are we here? Okay, so our new science vessel is a sorcerer class. It's the Androcles. It has had a supporter upgrade. We managed to get two upgrades done while we were building them, which was totally great. So that's an advantage for the ships. The only disadvantage they have is they've got totally green crews, and I think that makes some difference in the game. I think your ship improves a lot, depending on the crew, as well as the commander. Supporter upgrade gives us speed and hull. It's nice. Fast and Furious gives us combat speed, and Programmer gives us combat aim. And it has a list of powers. We'll get familiar with them in combat. I tried to pick good combinations. There are a couple of attacks we have that we don't have the ability to put the condition on for them to exploit. We've got the Pericles, an archer class tactical, and it's had the Stinger upgrade, which gives it speed and evasion. I thought that was good. It's got fantastic evasion. And Oberon has Maverick, so he's got damage bonus. Pirate Hater, so damage against pirates, and Ace Pilot, so evasion plus two, and the Lenore, our new engineering class ship, our Guardian class engineering ship, rather. The Lenore, well, looks like Valentina gets plus 5% health, plus 10% damage, and plus 10 against pirates. She doesn't have any upgrades to her ship. And this is the fleet. And so we've got our junior officer still at work here. She's got 4 days left recruiting cadets. And when she's done that, young Kay, she'll hop in one of the other ships and go start collecting stuff, because we've got ships that we can actually send out. So we're going to go for it. I don't even know what kind of fleet is waiting for us. I didn't even really look. We're going to fly to Boomerang and attack those Krull jerks. Because, yeah, we have to. Okay, so. Well, we pick the weakest first. What do these all do? Inflicts panic, exploits disruption, heals everyone, exploits disruption. So I guess we inflict panic. Or we speed time already on one of these other ships. So what do they have? Backstab's nice. So it'd be nice to have backstab recharge fast, actually. So we're going to quicken on the ship with backstab, so that backstab maybe will recharge faster. And then perfect, we'll do a backstab on the smaller ship and see if it works. So, disabled. Great, so now we are going to inflict crew panic with a disruptor beam, which damages the crew. And the crew did panic, and we did them some harm. Now can we exploit that crew panic? Yes, disintegrate hull exploits crew panic. Oh, and that did fabulous damage. We got dinged. So he's got ship disabled. I don't think anything exploits that. So we can inflict weapons disruption, which I believe our sorcerer class is able to exploit, so we will do that. Resisted the effect. So we've got some different stuff. This was the one that exploded weapons disruption. That's the one that does the most damage too. But nothing's gonna one-shot him, so we might as well just do the crew panic inflictor. And then take him out with... Oh, well, this will one-shot him guaranteed. And it hits everyone, except the guy that dodged it, of course. So now we are going to inflict crew panic on the Elder Basher. It worked. So we exploit it with Disintegrate Hull. Oh, that is fantastic. What do we got here? We can do... He's got no conditions, so let's do Bullseye. It does really good damage. Oh wow, it just absolutely stomped him. So I don't know when this ship will get another turn, so we're going to do adaptive armor right now and start the healing process. Oh, sweet. So we've got no conditions. Can we inflict? We can inflict breach and vulnerable. Inflict vulnerable with that. This seems good. So we breached him. And now he's breached and vulnerable, and Bullseye exploits vulnerable, so we'll probably kill him with this shot. That'll take him out. So we took a nick. And we got our rewards. Let's see what our timers look like. Oops. I don't know what happened there. Belief system. I missed something, obviously. That's too bad for me. Let's check our timers on everything. 23 and 26 days left, so we probably have time to go take care of this portal. I believe Woof Woof Gurr will be going there. Oh no, what did I... Snarl. And back to the station for a sec. How's she doing? One day left. Oh, that just makes me so disappointed when that happens. Okay, she's recruited 5 crew. Let's go to show location. And let's get her on something else, if she can do something else, if there's anything else available. I think all the explorers are out of her level, so she's going to go in the Dark Matter Multiplier and do Dark Matter Creation 1, because we're probably going to need it by the time we get home. We're going to be in crud shape. Oh, actually, no, she's going sailing. I take it back. Let's take her off that task. Cancel task. She's going sailing, so star map, she's gonna go to the fuel refinery first, send a new fleet, and we will send Seeker the Prospero. It's a solid ship with a solid crew, so we will just... Oh wait, she needs an engineering ship, right. So she'll be taking this anti-Satan out for a spin. She will launch. She will repair all, just in case she runs into Trabalio. And then she's going to start some search. Transfer 38 fuel. Got that. That's nice. Leaf system. She'll go get the next load of fuel. Just to get her done. Correct. We're going to continue our own voyage towards that nasty portal. Grab that 29 fuel, new system, and now there's a colony here, so we'll send Santa Satan there. Seems perfect. 31 crew aboard. Let's hope we don't get in trouble. New system, what else is going on? A bunch of stuff up here is all ready to be harvested, so we'll send the Santa fleet up there. Might as well. And we're in combat. Here we go. Here we go, and this is going to be nasty, I do think. So, do I have anything that hits all enemies on this? No. So, we'll warp space-time on the Lenore and see how that works for us. And we're gonna use backstab right away. That's what I should have done, is had the backstab ship on quick recharger. Okay. So we will salvage harpoon him. He did get breached. Can we exploit the breach? Yes, and we can put crew panic on exploiting it. So maybe it gives you a higher chance to get your crew panic if you're exploiting it. And it did good damage. So he's got panic and disabled. We've got disintegrate, which exploits panic usually quite effectively. And I think we can finish him off with the incisor beam right now. He's down, so nice. This inflicts vulnerable, so we'll take on this adult bath, sure with it. Disable countermeasures. He resisted that. So we will inflict crew panic on him with this disruptor beam. He resisted that as well, and he took a good stab at us, the big jerk. Now this exploits sensors offline, so we can't, it's not, well, it's not we can't use it, but, you know. Inflicts weapons disruption, we can exploit that, so we're going to do it. And then one of these exploits weapons disruption, the incisor beam, so let's see how much we can do with that. Not a lot, but maybe we just got a bad roll on it. So let's inflict vulnerable if possible. Yeah, and we did super damage, and bullseye exploits vulnerable and does super damage, so... See what that did. That took him out. So we're gonna do adaptive armor right now. Wow, he didn't finish healing, did he? Well, that's okay. We'll inflict weapons disruption here if possible. And then, oh, we can fire adaptive armor without recharge, which is beautiful. And exploit or inflict. Inflict. Leave the exploit or leave the condition on him. So yeah. And then we can exploit that crew panic. He's taking a poke at us. Let's try to put a weapons disruption. What does this do? Exploits vulnerable. He's got weapons disruption. So no point doing that. Well, that does fantastic damage, and we've never fired it, so we'll try it. I think we'll do adaptive healing again. What? Oh, I hit the wrong button. I was gonna do torture. But we're gonna just try to just keep healed here as best we can, so... Let's hull breach and try to vulnerable. We failed on the vulnerable, unfortunately. So we'll try to inflict the crew panic here. Did a nice hit, and then we'll just bash him. We'll just bash him, and we got pretty much healed in the combat, so that worked out for our benefit. Closed that portal. Then we'll go to the next most in danger place, which is going to be another one of our poor colonies, man. So get the timers out. 19 days left on Regulus. So is this Regulus? Yeah, that's Regulus. You guys are in trouble now. And where is Santa Satan? She's in transit to Menkar, so let's just fire both those guys along. Kay Fry had an accident while traveling and lost 14 fuel, not a complete disaster. She's reached Menkar, transferring 35 crew aboard, leaving system. And she will travel to this dark matter extractor now at a cost of 2 fuel. 201 dark matter, that's pretty nice. Hope she makes it home safe, right? So we'll send her to this colony now. And we are in combat with some pretty serious looking Krull. I've got to say. We don't have any all enemy attacks. We're gonna ban space time on the on the Lenore. After all, she's the one without enhancements. So we will immediately backstab the little one. Oh, that's what I should have done, is sped up the backstab guy. Well, that's okay. Got it disabled. We will try to also get it hull breached. We did, and it's vulnerable. We took a nasty hit, and we are weapons disrupted. Okay. So we've got hull breach and vulnerable. Warp atomic structure exploits hull breach, so we will use it. And, I mean, combinations aren't always the right thing, but that worked. He resisted the crew panic. So he's got vulnerable, and I don't think we can do anything with vulnerable on him right now. So I wonder what brace does. Let's just fire it, just see what happens. So that gives us 50% damage resistance and increased threat, so they'll probably fire at us. Well, that's pretty nice, actually. And he's got vulnerable, can't do anything. We'll do disruptor and then try to inflict crew panic. It worked. He got healed. We can exploit the crew panic. Why did that do so little? That was strange. We'll try to inflict the crew panic again and try to do it again. Okay, we got crew panicked. That's all he's got on him, so let's inflict weapons disruption if possible. It worked. Chaos beam hit us. Exploiting our weapons disruption. Okay, this guy might be down to one shot status here. Yeah. He is. So we'll try to inflict vulnerable on the smaller of these two. And we got it. And nothing disables ship here. Oh, this inflicts ship disable, but it's suicide run, so no. Bullseye exploits vulnerable, and it has pretty good damage, so we're gonna just do that. Did pretty good damage. We're gonna need to do some healing on that ship pretty soon. We will try to inflict the crew panic with the disruptor beam. He resisted the crew panic. He has no conditions on him. So we can inflict weapons disruption if possible. Looks like we did disrupt his weapons. Now can we exploit that from up here? Exploits weapons disruption. Torture. 24 to 49 to crew plus 110 by 2 rounds. We'll take it. Oh, that's really cool. He resisted the effect, so it did nothing to him. We are going to go for repair drone on this ship. That helped quite a lot. We're taking a beating. Let's see, we've got no conditions, so we will try to again inflict weapons disruption on him. He resisted it again. He's a dreadful little devil that way. We'll just try for max damage. Exploits be darned. Oh, we gets zimazering. We're gonna repair drone again. Get caught up there. Then we're gonna get started on this guy. We're gonna bend space-time on the Pericles. I don't mind the Greek names. And then we're gonna try to backstab this thing and disable it, because we got backstab back. Worked, that's awesome. I won't do the triple heal quite yet. We will try to inflict crew panic. Yeah, it did panic his crew. What does that do to him? Minus 100 evasion. Oh, that's pretty sweet. So we'll try to get weapons disruption on him. He resisted the effect. Did some good damage. And this ship will salvage harpoon him to get a hull breach and vulnerable. That's pretty good. I gotta say. So he's got panic, hull breach, vulnerable. I don't think we can exploit any of those. No, we can't. So maybe we'll fire the first of our triple healings here. Because we've got more of them left. And we will try to... Okay, we can exploit vulnerable with bullseye. So that's probably our best shot right now. It's a good weapon. Oh yeah, that did absolutely striking damage to him. He's pretty much one-shot status, so we'll heal again. And we'll hit him with everything we've got. What's the best hit you've got? Well, not ramming. So it's disintegrate hull. It's not going to do enough. It did do enough. Oh, we had crew panic and exploded it. Nice, so we got out of that full healed. That was awesome. Nobody's here to come here, so that's fine. Now, she is in transit to Delta, Virginia. And we are going to send Woof Woof Grr after this fleet of guys. So we'll see who gets there first. Combat first. Okay, so we will bend space-time on the Pericles. So I think it might be the more devastating of the ships. And now it is going to backstab the larger ship to try to take it out of shooting while we finish off the little ship with maybe a couple of hits. So let's disruptor beam, try to crew panic them. Panic their crew, then let's exploit the crew panic with disintegrate, and they're down with 568 damage. That was amazing. Let's try to inflict weapons disruption. It worked. And then let's exploit weapons disruption with the incisor beam. Did very nice damage. We will do that same combo again. Yeah, I think we're about to finish them, so I'm going to do our adaptive armor. Well, maybe I was premature. Nope. I wasn't. Well, this fleet cleaned up those Krull pretty smooth. Transfer 108 materials to fleet leaf system. Where even are we? Okay, so, what's this? Send a fleet to New Terra. Oh, we're almost ready to do that now, actually. We're almost ready to do that. We're going to send the big fleet down to this materials mine. Since they seem to have no one to fight right this second, so that's awesome. And she's in transit, so... we go grab those 38 crew. New system. And... nothing else really for her to do here. Not much fuel to pick up on the way home either. So she's going to save fuel and return to base. And he is in transit. So let's hit return home. Get those materials. Leave system. See what else is down here for us to grab. A bit of dark matter, a tiny bit of materials, nothing special. Got a full dark matter here, so we'll send Woof Woof Grr to get it. That'll be all good. Grab that 200 dark matter, that's quite nice. Leave system. And then we will also return home. Everybody will go home. So 104 crew, 201 dark matter from that mission. And 225 materials and 200 dark matter from that mission. Not bad. Let's go to Starbase right now. I think we're pretty much good on missions for the moment. So let's double check that. We've got two messages. New Terra and automate resource gathering. And cadets and stuff gain some reputation, so those ships are getting seasoned. Which is great. That's really what they need. They'll take on those two further pirate fleets, maybe, before we move on. Yeah, might just do that. I've got an idea to put K to work in the Terran Starship tier. Wrong start. Tier 2, right? Yeah. And we've got the Archer Stalker, but what was it? Is our ship a Guardian? I believe it is. No, not the Santa Satan. The Lenore. It's a Guardian class, so. Back here, let's see if we can get a upgrade. So, Defender gives it plus 10% hull and plus 5 evasion. That's really nice. Plus 10% damage and plus 5 speed. Let's go with the 10% hull and 5 evasion. K is not able to do this. Well, we're going to give her some combat experience instead then, basically. So, since it is an engineering ship and she is an engineering pilot, we're going to put Valentina Chow of the Lenore in charge of upgrading her own ship. Time estimated 4 days. And then we're going to send a newly composed fleet against these pirates. Elite Shrieker, send a fleet. And we will redo Hapland at this point. So, we're going to leave the Prospero in? No, not the Prospero. We're going to leave the Santa Satan in and put K. Fry in charge of her, yes. No, we're not going to take the Fortinbra out. We're going to take out the new one. So, oh, but is she working? She's working, upgrading her own ship. Wait a minute, no, I'm getting confused by who's who here. So we put the Pericles in there, and we put the Androcles in there, and the Santa Satan rides along in the middle with its victory crowns, and that's Hapland reconfigured. So we're going to go for it. And I guess we better save our game first, in case we do something crazily wrong. And we're all saved, and we'll go back to game, and we will launch that fleet and see what happens. And this should get our... I mean, we want a new officer soon. Pirate Savick hailing our fleet. Federation officer, this one has a remunerative proposal for you. Affirm if you would like to hear specifics. Take another course, and I will instead of pressure outside the... We have no truck with pirates. We can say, a collective pirate, how'd that come about? Is that some kind of strangely worded threat, or whatever you're selling, Savick? I'm not interested. She diverged from the collective. Enough said. I don't want the proposal. She says she's dangerous and that can be to our advantage. And I think we'll eliminate her, and she accuses herself of being vicious and paranoid. She might be right. Savick's vessel veers angrily towards your position. And it's a fairly heavy crew. So we're just gonna start hitting them with stuff right here. Maximum damage on this little guy. Oh, he got a shot off. Now we got a shot off. We'll just polish that little unit off. It's still shooting while the other guy shoots. That's kind of interesting. Okay, we'll try to get crew panic on this one. Looks like they did get panicked. Oh, different powers, eh? Ah, exploits crew panic. And ship disabled, nice. That saves trouble for us. And Bullseye will have a very high chance of simply taking that ship out. Yeah, gone, so it's time for adaptive armor to be fired. And then we'll deconstruct it, hull breach it. Resisted the effect, little devil, and give us some damage too. We'll inflict a crew panic on it. And then... Oh, right, we can't exploit crew panic here. We'll try to offline it, basically. It resisted that effect. It's a toughie. It's a tough little ship. We'll try to get the... Oh, we can't exploit crew panic with any of these, so we will... I don't know. We'll hit it with whatever does our most damage, basically. Hi, Snooper. There's my dog. That didn't do much damage. Flak barrage is just this ship's probably maximum here. And... I'll speed the Androcles so that we can run a quick heal if we end up needing to. And for that, we're gonna torture you. Tortured. 240% base damage over 2 rounds, that seems great. We will deconstruct it. We will... What are we gonna do here? We'll go with Bullseye, because it's our high damage unit. Yeah, this fleet doesn't have combos, eh? And we're gonna fire that adaptive armor, because the next shot of anything kills that thing. And then we will laze it down. Destroying it. Okay, that was good. We got rid of another bunch of pirates. We don't like pirates. They killed Tim. Wait. Noble Federation opponent. This is Lote. You've proved your worth as a noble and brave combatant, and I, Lote of the Exlarianthi, once served 4 years in a state facility for aggravated bravery. In fact, you are so worthy that I, Lote, he who jumps, kicks sharks, bestow upon you my greatest secret, the location of my materials hoard. You want to follow these coordinates right away, I'm sure, so just ignore my escape shuttle. Nothing to see here. Move along. So one of them got away, but that's okay. And we got a bit of extra stuff, and we're getting a slight bonus on what we received due to our multiplier. So there's the materials hoard. And here's the elite wraithers, so we're gonna go after them. Haplund is. It's not a well-composed fleet. What is our other officer busy doing? We don't remember. We will figure it out. It's not a well... Will Alidila of the Wraithers is hailing us. So you're the ones who took out Coot, that blustering Exlar. He was more dangerous than he came across, so I applaud you. You know what? How about I give you the position of the Admirax's secret base? If you can take out Coot, maybe you can take him out too. I'll even throw in a few resources. That sound attractive? Refuse. Odd choice. I guess I'll have to kill you now. Shame. I like her face there. Willa's vessel powers up its guns, moves to combat position, and... Oh, since we don't have anything to really upload on them, let's just, let's start with something as nasty as possible against that little guy. Oh, that did very little to him. He returned damn near as much damage to us. Let's see if this does the job. That probably did the job. Oh, we took a little bit of damage on that. We will deconstruct this guy. Hull breached. So can we exploit the hull breach? Yes, with warp atomic structure. That's not a very good... Actually, it does pretty good damage. I take it back. Not bad. So, we'll take it. Good damage, yeah. Good solid bit of damage there. We're gonna disable that thing. I should have disabled the big one. It'll probably have a vicious attack that it uses on us. Yeah, that was dumb. That was a waste. I'll bend space-time on the ship with disable to get disable back faster. At least I think it'll work that way. Unless it's just turn by turn. I'm not sure. What's going to take him out? None of these are going to take him out. So... This guy, since he can't do enough damage to one-shot that, he'll deconstruct the big guy and breach his hull. Ship disabled, that's annoying, isn't it? This could probably finish this guy, so let's go ahead and use it. And then we've got inflict weapons disruption, that's good. And then we've got repair drone overdrive, we'll throw on the Androcles. So it might slowly regenerate over time, I guess. We are going to return a crew panic for your... Oh, we could have exploded the hull breach to get that crew panic. That was too bad. Oh, and we can't exploit crew panic anyway. We'll just get weapons disruption on him. He resisted that. He's getting pretty low. We'll run adaptive armor now. Didn't quite finish our healing process there. Pretty close. Ah, if we get another chance. What's our lowest damage here? This one. Yeah, so then I get another chance at adaptive armor, which is nice, and then I get a shot which should finish him. Leaves us in perfect shape. I love it. Because it just saves dark matter, you know. Stuff's valuable. After scouring the wreckage left over from the fight, our crew was unable to find any trace of the Admirax's secret base coordinates with no immediate avenue for finding that information. We'll need to bide our time. Yeah, we'll find it. So, let's send the fleet here. And how's our taskies going in here? What was she doing? I don't even know what she's doing. Valentina, she's upgrading her own ship. Oh, and then she'll be doing another... someone will be doing... her or someone else will be doing another upgrade immediately after that, so... nobody's gonna go on any harvest missions except this one. Hangar Terran Tier 2 has completed its task. Show location. So that's great. So now we could do the Guardian Berserker, which does damage and speed. Or we could do the Sorcerer Scrapper, which does damage and evasion. The sorcerer. Ooh. Valentina. Get to work. 10 days. I think it's faster if it's the officer appropriate to the type of ship. But that's okay. She's going to be doing that. We've got fuel enough to do what we're doing, eh? We've arrived at the location of the materials hoard. There appear to be some hostiles on the surface. Beam down. More experience for our... oh dear, we're not in great shape. Deploy officers, heal all. That's better. Ooh, they're off to a start. Mass paranoia. See if we can confuse them a little. One of them got confused. Diseased spit. Afflicted. Well, let's try arc laser. This should blind them if it hits them. Or at least it has a chance to. So they're both blinded. And, they're really not in good shape, are they? Mind toss. Exploits blinded. And we could probably polish this guy off with one round of invasive surgery, I bet. Not quite. So let's cut all his arms and legs off. We did. Hi, Byron. That's the other dog who's staying here. I'm babysitting him for a little while. We've recovered the materials. We should return to Starbase. Lucas Beaumont gained built like a brick house. I didn't even feel a thing. Ground combat health plus 10%. Well, that's nice. Okay. What kind of missions are we looking at? The return home, automate, and materials hoard, which... right, returning the materials to the Starbase is how we complete, so we will return the fleet home. Straight away. Oh, and another fleet's coming. Materials have been safely transported to Halcyon 6's engineering bay. We get a reward of 300 materials. We're getting a decent stock. We need dark matter too, but our generation planets should be building up pretty quickly too, so we'll launch a small fleet soon. We've got a small pirate fleet approaching us. will we'll recompose. Well, we've got one of the officers busy, so we'll actually respond with the fleet we've got. So we'll send a fleet to Starbase Approach. Haplin it is. Launch. And we'll just be right there when they come. Raider fleet is bombarding the station. Show location. Great. I'm glad we jumped out. I hope we do okay here. I think we will. I think I'll bend space-time on this Pericles ship. Because it is the powerful ship. But I wonder if crew gain experience per, like, time they hit things or something. Why doesn't he backstab the big ship and try to put it out of action while we work on the little guys? So we'll deconstruct this little guy, reaching its hull, and then we'll warp atomic structure, exploiting the hull breach, and see what we get out of that. That's done. Worked pretty good. So this one has no conditions on it. We will just grab Inspired out for ourselves. Oh, put him down to one-shot status, so we will just one-shot him. That's good. This inflicts weapons disruption, so we'll do it. He resisted the effect. We will deconstruct. Warp atomic structure to take advantage of the hull breach from deconstruct. Although we should leave that to pickle for a round or two, I guess, really. Ooh, critical hit. It didn't do a lot of damage, though, did it? Yeah. We'll just inflict weapons disruption again. This time it worked. Weapons disrupted. We'll do nano machine repairs on the Pericles. Probably was actually a waste of a turn. We will. We will do disruptor beam. Panicked his crew and did him some harm. Can we exploit crew panic here? No. So we'll just. His weapon's already disrupted, so let's just do Bullseye, because it's got good damage. Okay, now we're going to do Adaptive Armor. Get ourselves healed up. We are going to deconstruct him. And then we will warp Atomic Structure to take advantage of that hull breach. And that did the job. He's out. Great, more combat experience for our little officer in training. Let's get that fleet back home. They are in transit to home. Okay, so got a few things to do out in the star systems here, so we want to send some fleets to exploit some things. Let's construct that and set it to going. So, pardon me. We'll send a fleet. Santa's. Wait, she's working. Right? No, she's not working. And she leveled up. She's got 2 skill points. So we'll increase her repair drone overdrive for sure. And we'll give her 25% plus 30% times a few rounds. We'll give her activate nano repairs to on her ground combat. It only works on self. And Lucas got promoted. And he can unlock his epic power matter reconstruction. So we're going to do that right away because it's pretty awesome power. So we've got. Yeah, alright, so let's get back out there. Fuel mission, that's Santa. And southerly mission will be that one, and we'll do a northerly mission with the other fellow. Send a fleet. Send me a fleet. Which one is it? Seeker? Well, we should send out a heavier ship if we're going to do anything, so let's just put the Androcles in Seeker and launch. And let's get out there. Grab those 38 fuel. Leave system. And she'll head... golly. Here first and clean this out. So... Santa heads there first. Works out probably well. 31 crew, grab them. Leave system. Now, next is this one. Send, seeker, redirect. Ah, it's kind of fun doing it. It would be neat to have like 5 fleets out at once. That may come with further play. I may end up having 5 fleets out at once. Right now it's 2. And yeah, I know I'm supposed to be automating. We've probably got the ability to get that done. We have to send fleets for these colonists anyway, though. And, right, she needs to turn around and head down here. Okay. Grab those 38 crew. New system. It's tempting to evacuate that particular one, really. Now, what about this dark matter collector? There isn't much in it, but I guess it's worth it, so we'll do it. Seeker will go there. 6 fuel. That's a bit of a cost. But I think we're doing okay on fuel right now. 117 materials. We're not going to upgrade the facility just yet. That's getting full. That's getting full. Just go for this one first. Santas, I can't believe that costs 5 fuel. It's ridiculous. Grab that dark matter. Leave system. Leave system. Okay, so I messed something up since he's stationed there instead of having been launched. Everyone should always be launched at all times, essentially. There's not many colonists there. We're going to let them pickle. I'm going to send him back for this small amount of fuel just on the way. Seeker goes there. And she's going to go get this dark matter. Okay, grab that up. It's not a lot, but it is good. There's only 84 there, but we're going to get it too. Santa's redirect. Engine overheated. 15 crew died on Kay's ship. That's rough. Tanger Terran Tier 2 has completed its task. Show location. Okay, so now we've got, let's scroll down. We've got the Guardian Berserker upgrade and the Archer Stalker upgrade left to do. So the Archer Stalker gives aim and damage to the Archer. The Guardian Berserker gives damage and speed. Speed is kind of gives you more turns. So we will put Valentina on that. Confirm, 4 days. And I guess the other person here, Oberon. Any explore tasks available? No, we're going to have to gain some levels first. So he can go to work in the dark matter multiplier. How high can he go? He's level 6, so he can do dark matter creation 275 dark matter. That does not seem like it's worth the time, to tell you the honest. Yeah, I kind of wish we could have him do something else. We need a level 7 for this. Okay. Task available in the cadet barracks. Recruiting crew. Okay, so we can... No. None of it makes sense. Oberon, what are you gonna do, buddy? You gotta have a task. I suppose he could get in a ship and head out. But I think we're just about done cleaning up. Oh, this colony is... Alright, fine, we'll send him there. And maybe there'll be some other stuff for him to scrape up. So we'll remake Search 2. And we'll put the Pericles in it, right? Helix, Dark Matter Extractor. Transfer 90 Dark Matter to Fleet. That's Great Leap System. So, she will go to the fuel refinery, unless he already is. I don't think so, though. I think he's going to the other one. That's cool, all three of them going. Grab 20 fuel at Centaurus, leave system. So now he is going to go home. Neanderthals. Engine overheated, 9 crew were lost on K's ship again. Man, that thing is a crew-eating pig. I'm sorry, that thing is unsafe. Oh, she's stationed. Never leave people stationed. Right. So she's gonna go return home as well. 104 crew, 72 dark matter, not very productive. She's back home. 117 materials, 216 dark matter, it's alright. And he's gonna root out this junk while we assign these people to some work in the station here. So, nobody's level 7? Oh, Lucas is. So, let's get Lucas on getting an officer in here. 12 days, yeah, the Krull will probably show up in that much time, eh? Wouldn't surprise me. Wouldn't surprise me. So we've got one person left to do work, so we are going to stick them in the Dark Matter Multiplier. K-Fry is going to do Dark Matter Creation 2, confirm task. 19 bloody days, that's just madness, eh? For 75 dark matter? What the hell? That seems crazy. There's gotta be something better for her to be doing. Yeah, she should actually be flying and not Oberon. Yeah, and that's the truth. And none of the Tier 3 ships should be out. That was my mistake, so we'll set her up with a fleet and send her out scoobying, and we'll bring the other ship back. Send a fleet, send you a fleet. Which one do we want? What does she fly? Is that her? That's her. Yeah, so that's the fleet we're gonna send. We'll let that other guy fly, but then we're bringing him home, because the Krull will be back any second, eh? So we'll take those 36 crew in the system, and then this ship will return home immediately. That should not be out. Hangar has completed its task. Show location, that is awesome, so... Now we've just got the Archer Stalker here, I think, left to do. So let's do the Archer Stalker. Valentina, it's on you. 10 days, that's awesome. We'll bring that other starship home. Wow, 208 materials, beautiful. what else is around here. There's 84 there, there's 36 thingies there, 30 there, so we'll get the 84. What fleet is this? Santa's. So we'll send Santa's there. Get that done. Grab those materials, this is great. New system. Well, it's a bit of a farming episode today, I guess, but it's nice to have some peacefulness out of this game. Okay, he's back. We just want everybody home. Wonder if he opened any explore tasks being back. Doesn't look like it now. Okay, well, we're not gonna worry about it then. Could assign him to get some crew. We've been losing crew. They'll recruit some crew. Keep busy. Oh, we got these guys up full up, eh? So, after grabbing that bit of dark matter, we better fly there. Why do I have that problem of hitting the button wrong like that? Grab those crew. It's not worth it. We'll send her here. And then get her home, I guess. Unless there's more stuff for her to do. I think we're gonna bring everybody home for now. Good retrieval. Nice run of stuff. We got a ton of... yeah, we got a krill portal on our hands. Okay. So we need to send Woof Woof Gur against it. And that, I think, will be the concluding fight. Oh my god. Adult Hulker. Okay, this is... Oh wow, young Impaler. Oh, what? This is not seeming very nice. People are on their tasks, but they're going to be pulled off them, so we're going to be saving game right here. Wow, what a nightmare. That's a remarkably powerful fleet. Remarkably powerful fleet. Send fleet against it. And we'll be sending Woof Woof Gur. And they're fully manned and they're ready to go. Yeah, they're busy, I don't care. No, we don't want to do it. We're just going to ditch all the tasks because we've got to go get them as fast as we can. Because they are going to spawn. Raider fleet is bombarding the station. Are you kidding me? It's a bit annoying. Guys have no consideration. What? Why? Why did it do that? Let's dispense some... Oh, no! Oops, it was Zeb, and I totally didn't read his voiceover, which I don't think I've ever read before, so... Whoops, guys, sorry. You'll have to pause read it. We're probably gonna take some damage here, man. Not what we need. Let's try to backstab the big thing, the Watchman there. Seriously, the ship. Ship disabled, so let's handle the ships. Highest damage. Just hit it. Oh, it evaded us, eh? Well, we'll disintegrate its hull then. Oh, that did some harm. Sheesh. That puts it to one-shot status, basically. Ah, triple shot all enemies. Nice. Oh, it evaded that, did it? Well, we'll just give it another poke. Even though we can't take any advantage of this, we're gonna into the fray on this little guy. Took him out too, and gave us that nice bonus. So now we'll try to get the hull breach on this guy. Hull breach invulnerable. So we can exploit the hull breach with crew panic or space time. That did quite a bit of harm. Oh! That was pretty harmful to our fleet, eh? So he's got panic and vulnerable on. Bullseye exploits vulnerable, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. Should do a fair amount of harm to him. 456. Okay, I think we're gonna do adaptive armor. And we'll just exploit that crew panic. And since he's just about no, we don't want to use matter reconstruction because I think it takes even longer to regenerate. Like, it's just crazy. We got him. I think it takes more than one combat to regenerate it, basically. Okay, we came out in good shape, too. So we're gone. He gains ship combat speed, and she gains ship combat aim, so we're gonna save game again. That went well. That's speed and aim, you know, like, that cannot hurt. Alright, we're gonna go after them again. I hope we've got the fuel. Yeah, we do. Go on, guys. Why did they stop there? Collided with space junk and lost 71 materials on emergency repairs. That's okay. Okay, combat with this truly severe fleet here. Wow, you know, like, I don't even know what to think. Let's get the crew panic on the little guy. Crew panicked. And let's get the backstab on the monstrosity. Ship disabled, that should give us a little more breathing space. What does our best damage here? I think actually we'll bend space-time on the one off. Oh, should have done it on the one that backstabs. I'm a fool. Well, it'll all work out in the end. Lenore is going to exploit the crew panic with disintegrate hull. Do nice damage. Oh, what? Just gonna finish that thing off. That was just serious madness, man. I can only triple heal, I can't. Oh, seriously. That was pretty awful. We'll try to get the hull breach on the young impaler. Got him, hull breached and disabled. He enraged himself. Gonna exploit that vulnerable. You're not disabled, vulnerable, so I'm gonna exploit that vulnerable. Did some very good damage with that. I might have to spend another adaptive armor. Now? I don't think I'll spend it now. Yeah, a bit of a question mark there, though. So we'll exploit that hull breach with warp atomic structure. That's the way to rock it. This is a really harsh fleet. So that... Whoa, that was painful, man. That was insane. So we'll exploit that crew panic. And he's gonna have to do adaptive armor again. We need another healing. I thought we had another healing device. Into the fray. Or no, let's disabling strike him. Get that weapons disruption on. Wow, we took some pain back. We have to do the super heal already here. Let's do the last adaptive armor right away. It didn't do deedly. So he's got weapons disrupted. Can we explode it? Oh, repair drone single ally. We do have it. Okay, we did have it. Dang, I should have been using it sooner. Okay, so weapons disrupted. We can't exploit it. We're gonna go ahead and into the fray. Didn't do a lot of damage. Wow, what? Not a reconstruction. Brutal. Wish backstab was recharged. We could one-shot this guy with suicide run, hey? Exploits vulnerable. He doesn't have vulnerable on. What has he got? Weapons disrupted. Let's do triple shot. It's just... since we're not gonna one-shot him, let's just... yeah, and then we can get him. That thing has insanely powerful weapons. I don't know what we're supposed to do against that. Bend space-time on the Lenore. If it hits us again, we're gonna blow up. So, Paragrown quick. Let's hope it scores well. Yeah, it scored pretty well. Regurgitate. Oh my god. That thing is just awful. Okay, let's try to inflict crew panic on it. We did panic its little crew. We will exploit the crew panic with... hang on, what have we got here? Exploits engines down. Let's exploit. Yeah, we'll exploit the crew panic right away. And then we're gonna try to inflict another crew panic. It worked. And we're going to attempt to ship disable it with suicide run. We disabled it. And we're going to exploit the crew panic with thingy blaster. And we'll try to inflict the crew panic again. Worked. Then we will hit it with a weapons disruption inflictor. And we will exploit the weapons disruption. Wow, it does a lot of harm. We'll exploit the crew panic. And then we'll just take our max damage here. Hopefully it will score. Wow, even our tier 2 starships got wrecked there. Just wrecked. Seriously. So we closed the portal. That was nuts. Nuts, I'm telling you. Tons to pick up along the way home out here, so... let's send... Santas to get fuel. And let's send these guys picking up colonists and the like, eh? So we'll start with this. Grab that fuel. Leave system. Grab that crew. They must have arrived right at the same time. Kind of neat. So, Santas will head south and start here. No, Santas will start here. Another run. And he will head this way. That bit of dark matter, we're gonna need every bit we can get, so. Getting the hang of this. Everybody's busy in flight, so. And we got some promotions. As soon as we get everyone back to Starbase, we'll get to the promotions. Transit to Regulus and stations at Menkar. So heading back, go to this colony. Mm-hmm. We've been attacked by pirates. Well, they've attacked the wrong fleet, didn't they? Well, they got the, ooh, that's really cool. The firewall mark too. A melt barrage. Well, its resistance is to hull breached. We're gonna just get the healing started here. Why didn't that do anything? That's what I don't get. Is why that didn't do anything. Backstab the slightly weaker ship. He resisted it. And disabled our ship. For that, we are going to try to hull breach him. And we've vulnerabled him, but not hull breached. We're getting tagged here. We'll try to get weapons disruption on him. Failed, I think. We'll exploit that vulnerable with a bullseye shot. That took care of him. So adaptive armor, heal, 99 plus 75 by 3 rounds. Well, we're gonna fire it again. It's supposed to give overtime healing as well, so... Let's hit him with the disruptor beam, try to get that crew panic going. He resisted the effect. We will hit him with disable countermeasures, see if we can knock down his weapons. He was made vulnerable by that, and hit us with a melt barrage. We take advantage of his vulnerable, the bullseye. Which does a just huge amount of damage, so we'll fire our last blade of healing thing. And we'll try to finish him off slowly, does the least, into the fray. Because, yeah, we don't want him to really do any more damage to us, but wouldn't mind that healing to get another round in. Yeah, let's get healed fully, eh? And then we'll just take him out. And we're fully healed, so we save dark matter, basically. That's the way. Where was that fleet even going, man? Regulus, colony, 36 crew, boarded, leave system. So... they will head to the fuel refinery. Woof, redirect. And they will head down here. Grab that little pinch of fuel there. Good to keep it topped up, that's for sure. Oh, and this colony is full, so Woof Gur goes there. 31 crew. Swear we just did that. Not worth it. So these guys are gonna return home. Shipwreck in space, salvage 96 materials. Okay, Fry's ship. Another 117 materials from this little facility. We're leaving it. This one's full too. So Santa's, redirect. Grab the 208 materials, that's great. We've got a lot of materials. I'm not ready to close down any of our stuff yet though, so send Santa's to get that dark matter. 102 of it. System. And this last dark matter we'll send Santa's to get. We'll let everyone else have some R&R time. 150 dark matter, leave system. Return home. So everyone's gonna have some relaxed time. The crew will have an open a new portal. We got some more crew, we got everything. We've got a really good stock of stuff right now. And we got some level ups to do. So Valentina's leveling up. Ramming speed could go up. She could get reinforced hull 1. She could get salvage harpoon 3. That's 20% damage. That's pretty solid. Activate nano repairs 1. Activate nano repairs 2. Ooh, Kirkish Haymaker 3. That'll be the one. Oberon Yilmaz. He can take backstab 3, so I think we're gonna go with it. Doesn't improve the recovery time. But we like backstab. Yes, we do. Okay, that's everyone's promotions taken care of. And everyone's, you know, time on their hands. Free to chill, there's a little fuel, there's lots of materials. We have plenty of tasks available, plenty of research we can do. Oh, and look, now we can research the Tier 3 hangar. Oh, well, stomp. And we even have the stuff to do it. But we'll only just barely do, so let's not do that right now. What we should do right now is save our game in a couple of slots here. We'll save in Splabian twice. And twice. Save. Gonna delete all these other saves quickly here. Oh, you have to go, are you sure, every time? Well, I guess that's sensible. But we're gonna get rid of these other saves. Clean that up a little bit. That looks much nicer. And so, yeah. That's today's episode. A little bit of farming, a lot of fighting. I hope you guys had fun here in space with me today. I am going to go get myself ready for bed. It's been a long day. And hope you guys have a good one. So until next episode, which will no doubt be exciting. I sure love this game, I got to tell you. Well, bye for now.